What are bait cars? Find out in police camera action at 10:35. Now, in the first of a two-part documentary, Sarah Ferguson is the Duchess on the estate.
Since leaving the royal family, the Duchess of York has worked as a charity campaigner.
We can go forward spreading the word with gratitude for this very moment in time.
Helping to raise awareness for a wide range of causes.
Can I come in?
Come in!
Oh, it's not Oprah Winfrey!
Last year, the Duchess of York brought her anti-obesity message to Hull, helping the Sargerson family to lose weight.
Do you like that, or do you hate it?
It's really nice.
She always says, I love being in the field. I love being out there helping people, and when she's there, she's just magic.
But her time in Hull made the Duchess realise the problems facing families across Britain are far greater than just obesity.
Young people go out with their mobile telephones and their knives now. I've noticed a lot more violence, I've noticed bad language. Literally, you can't get young people to even do joined-up writing, let alone joined-up sentences. Because of all the things that I saw in Hull, it has inspired me to do this film.
The Duchess will spend a week on a Manchester housing estate to learn more about the problems of so-called broken Britain. Drugs, crime, and a breakdown in community spirit.
You probably feel as if you're doing loads and stuff like that. We all appreciate it.
I don't properly feel it. I am doing it, so it's not a problem.
Yeah, but something needs to be done because it's not getting any better.
Yeah.
And it's getting worse and worse and worse. Do you know what I mean? And eventually it will end up like America, won't it?
Hello.
But can the Duchess find a solution and inspire the locals to change their estate for good?
What's it like? Is it very boring?
No, it's not boring. Shit.
Let's get on to the community spirit and see if we can't make changes ourselves to get to see what we can do to get some energy going. OK, firstly, High Lanes, Royal Lodge, and Dummer, right. And they need to do the Victoria and Albert Museum. Who's making a note of all this?
It's February 2009.
I just can't believe no one's made me a cup of tea or coffee.
And the Duchess of York has been living back in Britain for a year.
Kate, can you tell Amanda on my call list I need Mark Stott, please, and immediately. He says his charity budget is completely finished, but he said if you open our office, we have an office budget for that, and we'll just won't use that, we'll just use it straight to you. And I didn't ask how much, because that would be greedy. That's your job.
After her success in Hull, the Duchess has again been inspired to take action.
John, I'm nearly with you. Here's Martin for a minute.
This time to tackle the problems of so-called broken Britain.
Now let's get on to the job in hand.
There is always going to be one person that say, why is she airing her views in public? Why is she putting her head above the parapet? Why doesn't she just go away and live in a hole with the worms?
It's Danny.
Hi, Danny.
So now I've come to comprehend and understand that. I still go on putting my head above the parapet because I believe that I'm on the public stage in order to help people get a voice out.
The Duchess will spend a week living in Northern Moor, part of Withinshaw in Manchester, one of the largest council estates in Europe. Once there, she will look for a solution to the problems destroying the quality of life on the estate.
These people around, they're committing crime after crime after crime after crime, and they're still allowed back out on the streets.
We've had people that have been stabbed, people that have been assaulted, robbed. It's gone on for years.
Show me one area in South Manchester with community spirit. There's none. None. Even your next door neighbours, nobody talks to you anymore. Everybody's petrified. Petrified.
Mammy kiss. Sarah, give
us
a kiss.
42-year-old Dawn McGowan has lived in Northern Moor for most of her life.
Not a lot in it since the kids robbed it.
Tired of what's happening on the estate, she signed up to help improve the local area, whatever the plan may be.
Come here. Good girl, sit down.
When I was a kid, you could play anywhere you wanted.
I spent hours and hours and weeks and years running around within Shire Park on a shitty old bike, a packet of custard creams and a drink of cordial, and we were happy. You can't let your kids do that now. You let your kids go to the park, they're going to get mugged for a decent phone or a piece of jewellery that someone's bought them or something. You can't do it.
Go on.
Dawn's unemployed and has three children.
Make me proud. You can all grow up to be models.
Joy, who's 17, Christiane, who's 13, and Callum, who's 9.
You're not going on the computer.
Dawn has adopted a very strict attitude to parenting. She lays down strict curfews and will not let her children travel unaccompanied after dark.
All three of you will have to have a chip in your neck. And then I can look on the computer and it'll tell me exactly where you are.
No thanks.
No thanks.
No.
Christiane's always pulling her face. I can't even go to the shops, I can't go in, I can't go there, you never let me go in.
But do you understand why I'm like that with you?
Yeah.
And why am I like that with you?
Because you're overprotective.
I'm overprotective.
Yeah.
Why am I overprotective with you?
She thinks something's going to happen everywhere we go. Going on the toilet. What's up? Are you all
too
right?
Too many things have happened around her, though.
I know.
Well, I wouldn't be much of a mum if I didn't keep an eye out for you, do you wonder?
The thing can be ridiculous, because nothing's ever really, really bad happened to you, because it'd absolutely break me out if anything did happen to you.
Say if you went out and got mugged or beat up or something like that, you'd think differently, and it does happen to kids.
I'm strict because I love them to death and I don't know what's happened to them, innit? If I didn't give a toss about them, they could run the streets and do what they wanted. I think any parent worth the salt is in exactly the same boat. You want to know where your kids are and who they're with and what company they're keeping in.
Northern Moor.
Apart from her time in Hull, the Duchess has little experience of life on a council estate.
I mean, that chap with the gun there, it's terrifying. I mean, that looks like a movie. What are they doing? I'm absolutely staggered with what you've just shown me. I mean, I knew it was bad, but I didn't realise they were proud of their disgraceful behaviour.
A week later, the Duchess is on her way to Northern Moor to experience real life on the estate.
Does it concern you when you read all these stories about what life is like in some
places? Well, I think that's why I've come here, to understand what life really is like in these communities. I think that it's all very easy for us to read a newspaper as we sit in our comfortable armchair at our very nice dining room table or our tables. And we have no idea, so we go, oh, isn't that appalling? Well, actually, hold on a minute. Why don't I come and see what it really, truly is like so that I can get a feel to see what they need to do in order to make changes.
With no room at Dawn's, the Duchess will stay in this B&B on the edge of the estate. It will be her home for the next week.
Hello.
Hi, would you like to
Thank you very much. Thank
Pleased
you.
To meet you.
Nice come to meet
in.
You. Thank you for having us.
Would you like to show me where I am?
Yes, I'll show you your room and then I'll show you down here so you know your way around.
Okay,
right,
thanks.
Come on.
Well, you can't possibly help people if you don't know what it's like.
You're in here.
Oh, that's nice. You got to know the area.
Lovely.
And you got to feel it. And you got to live the life to really want to champion it.
Well, it's lovely, isn't it? Yeah.
I wouldn't want my children to be frightened to go outside.
Hiya, baby. Let's kiss.
Dawn knows a well-known person is coming to tackle the problems on the estate, but hasn't been told who.
I am nervous. I think you'd have to be a bleeding half-wit not to be. I mean, I'm welcoming a stranger to the house, aren't I, really? But I'm just... My mum said to me, treat it as if one of the gas men are coming in to check your meters. Right, mum. I'm nervous. I'd rather go to court, put it that way.
She doesn't know who's coming, and so she might sort of say, oh, I don't want her. What does she know? You know, who does she think she is coming in here, you know? How can she relate to this? So, yeah, there's always going to be that risk, but hopefully once she gets talking, it'll be OK. But who knows? If she says, no, I don't want you in my house, well, then fine. Then we go and think again.
I don't suffer fools gladly.
And anyone that looked down the nose at me, I'd just tell them to do one. You don't come in and put your nose down at me.
walk a day in my shoes.
Still to come.
Hello.
The Duchess wastes no time getting to know the locals.
Is it very boring?
No, it's not boring. Shit.
On a dusky night, I think that I wouldn't walk their way. Very intimidating.
The Duchess of York is spending a week living on a Manchester housing estate to work out how to improve life for residents. Local mum Dawn McGowan has also signed up to help improve the estate. She knows a well-known person is coming to see her, but hasn't been told who.
Is anyone you don't want to come?
Someone that we don't know who it is. We're looking at each other and say, who's that?
It would be awkward, wouldn't it?
Neil? Neil? Car, watch, bags.
I'd have to say I'm sorry, not being rude, but who are you? what are you actually off? Don't say Hollyoaks because I never watch it.
Good, sir. Come on in, love. Just tell me, where's the bull mastiff, please?
She's in the back garden.
Oh, good. I love her. Can I talk to her?
Of course you can. Come in. Watch your jacket, though. Fancy wearing black when I've got a beige dog.
Oh, my heavens.
Many of Dawn's friends have also turned up to greet the Duchess.
Hello. What's your name?
David.
Hi, David. What do you do?
Gardening.
Hi.
I'm Joy.
Is Dawn your mum?
Yeah.
Good. Hello. And how old are you, Joy?
17.
Are you? Good age. Like me, same age. We are actually, I think, like 16-year-olds. So we're fine. Okay? Good. I just look old.
This is my middle one.
Hi. Oh, you are. So who's that one then?
That's the mate.
All right.
Callum's in the box room.
Right. Have I met Callum?
He's upstairs. He got a bit camera shy before and got very upset.
Do you want me to quickly just rush upstairs and say hello to Callum?
Yeah, you can do if you want, mate.
Hi, Callum. My name's Fergie. Can I say hello?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. Your mum thinks that you might not know me.
I know.
OK, all right. Have you heard of the Queen of England? The Queen of England?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? You know, the one with the crown on her head and all that. OK, so I married her son. So I married a real-life prince. I know. Get out of here. And so I just wondered over the next few days whether you might give me a hand. Perhaps you can take me around the local and see some of your friends?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. You'll be my mate then. Look after me. OK, cool. See you in a minute.
See ya.
See ya.
I might be living in a council house in middle Manchester, but my kids are my life. And I don't want anything to happen to them. I'd kill for the kids. And I don't care if you're not supposed to say that, but I would kill for my kids.
What's your greatest fear as they walk out that door?
Drugs. I think myself that if your relationship breaks down with your kids, if you take your eye off that ball for 10 minutes and someone else comes in and says, I can fix that for you, that's when you've lost your kid, you're knackered. And never take me off the ball. My worst nightmare would be anything happening to my kids like that.
How do you get your children to understand they're not to follow them?
I don't let them play with half of them.
You don't?
It might sound snobby, but I don't let them out. No. There's only certain people. I only have close people near my kids. And I don't care who it offends.
Right.
So I know that there's stuff out there, and I know I'm not with them all the time. And I know what the mates talk about and what they get up to.
So you talk very honestly to them?
I talk very honestly to them. I've got to be the friend and the discipliner, haven't I?
This must be very sad for you to see that.
To find out what they think about their mum agreeing to help her...
Ladies?
The Duchess goes to speak to Dawn's daughters, Joy and Christiane, and their friend, Jamie Lee.
Now then, quite interesting. I've had a little chat to mum.
What I really want you all of you to really understand is just how important Britain is. We've got to get the pride of Britain back.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got to get everybody saying we love Britain. And we've got to know that what the great job the traditional values of this country do. So that's what we're here to do with Mum.
Is it quite difficult to have such a strong mum, or is it fine?
No, that's right.
It's all right. That's right. Do you have to, every time you go out the front door, do you, like, sort of have to...
Tell her where you're going, yeah.
I think all mums have a tendency to sometimes have to pull up the barrier fence pretty hard, you know, and say, no, you cannot. I think we all have that. I mean, I've got two teenage... No, Beatrice is 20 and Eugenie's 18. And there are times when I have to be cruel to be kind and put the wretched barrier fence down.
We love our mum.
Having spent the afternoon getting to know the family, the Duchess heads to the B&B for her first night stay in Northern Moor.
So you look forward to showing her around tomorrow?
Yeah, not a problem. I'm quite looking forward to it now. I feel a lot calmer now. Yeah. And I have got loads to say about it. I've been brought up round here, haven't I?
At the B&B, the Duchess ponders the challenges of bringing up kids on the estate.
It's good to be a friend and a mother. And I got a lot of criticism when everybody said, oh, you should just be a mother and not a friend. And I'm glad Dawn and I agree on that. I think it's good to be a friend and a mother.
She's really worried. There's lots of dramas.
She's really worried about the drugs, she's really worried about the local area. She really doesn't know if it's going to be possible.
Did you have a good night's sleep?
Yeah, brilliant. The speed that I go at, that I'm very happy to sleep anywhere, really. Park bench, bed sit, bed and breakfast. To be honest with you, I close the window. You know, I like fresh air, but not when you're at the traffic lights. A lovely B&B, mural's fabulous, very comfortable. Couldn't recommend it more highly, but just don't open the window.
Dawn decides to show the Duchess round the estate. Their first stop, the local shopping parade at Sale Circle. It used to be the thriving centre of the community, but it's experienced a marked decline in recent years.
What is that shop? Is that it?
It's basically, that's it.
It's a shit hole.
It's never used, it's just sat there, full to the brim of rubbish. This used to be a fruit shop, and you came up and you'd have all the stalls outside with all the fresh fruit, and at Christmas you'd have all the Christmas trees way up for you to pick what size you wanted. All these were grass verges. Now they drive the cars up on them and they put these bollards, and I don't know what for, because they just ignore them and drive right on the pavement. There used to be a florist here. If you want a bunch of flowers now, unless you've got a car, so go to Northington or to Tesco's, you don't stand a chance at getting a bunch of flowers round here. The off-licences recently shut down because it kept getting robbed. The place is full of takeaways and solicitors. And we know the crime rate's gone up, but we don't need that many solicitors. They should bring us some fruit shops.
If you look everywhere now, you see the family funeral directors, and then you see solicitors, solicitors, solicitors. Do you know what? It's tragically sad. It's got an air of misery.
Cheese and salad.
Oh, that looks really nice. Thank you. I might have a bit of tuna as well. Is that all right?
That looks fun.
That looks lovely, Phil. Thank you.
It's clear that the area needs to improve, but the Duchess is unsure how to make that happen.
It appears the area is so neglected, and it's just not... No one really cares. You know, that's the sense I've got, is that it's all about them, you know, and it's not about us. It's not the community spirit. Dawn said there used to be flower markets. I like that idea, and it's a sense of colour and it's a sense of tradition. And I think if we can get it looking aesthetically lovely and flowers and colour and magic like that, I think it would be a very good thing to do.
The Duchess decides to get more views about life on the estate.
Hiya, Jane. You all right, love?
And soon realises that the problems are far more than just cosmetic.
Where do you live?
Just on Wiggish Road.
Do you?
It's just gone worse and worse and worse. More gangs round the streets and
hoodies and things like that. It is quite frightening.
There's her husband now, Mr. Brown.
Hiya, Mr. Brown.
There was an incident just 2 days ago. I witnessed a grown man beating the living daylights out of a young woman on the street.
It's not nice, not as nice.
Isn't it?
At New Year, some lads did they knock on your door, Edith, them lads that took that money off you?
To pick on an old lady like you, that kid's a coward, isn't he?
He is. I think he's a coward.
Well, people haven't got any morals anymore. Three or four lads will jump on a guy and kick hell out of him. It's a different way of life today.
It's because they're bored, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? What, they need something for the kids, do you know what I mean?
Nice to meet you.
You tend to want to just keep yourself to yourself, mind your own business and not interfere with what's going on, because that's the safest way to be.
OK, so where's Lisa?
Hi, I'm Lisa.
Are you?
Dawn takes the Duchess to see Dave and his partner Lisa, who Dawn's known since school.
I was born in Withenshaw, but it has changed. And even the last 5 years, I've noticed a big change. I don't know if you have, Dawn, but I've noticed a real big change.
Last year, their eldest son was attacked in the local park.
Do you know why they attacked him?
Not really, no. Just
they just did it just for the sake of doing
basically,
it?
Basically, yeah.
He was playing in the park with his mates and then loads of them started coming and he just jumped in and started attacking him.
Really? Dear, how difficult. But does it make you feel sad?
I don't know what it is with people. They just want to either destroy things or make people's lives a misery. Mm. It really is a small minority as far as I can see. Mm. But it's that minority that's winning.
Yeah.
Every morning I go out and pick rubbish up.
And do you find lots of rubbish? Hello.
Some of our neighbours.
Word has got round that the Duchess is filming on the estate, attracting youths from the local area.
How are you doing?
Hello. What's with the cameras and that?
Well, we're just, making a documentary on how we can make some changes around here and stop all the litter and seeing if we can't get more sort of community spirit going here. You'd help us, wouldn't you? We want to try and, get everybody working together and seeing how we could make it better for young children to grow up in, good area to grow up in. How old are you?
18.
Do you go to college?
No.
What do you want to do with your life?
Uh-oh.
And what's it like? Is it very boring?
No, it's not boring. Shit.
But don't you think the government are, like, just allowing it to carry on the way it is? Because it keeps everyone happy, doesn't it?
Well, I don't know. I think that we can help the government make changes. I think it's too easy to blame everybody else when we don't empower ourselves. So that's what I want, is to not complain and let's get on to the community spirit and see if we can't make changes ourselves to get to see what we can do to get some energy going. You want to get them motivated and they don't know where to put themselves, and so this is when the vicious circle starts. Boredom, drugs, violence, crime, off we go. It's pretty bad luck for them, actually, because they probably wouldn't harm you, but they look menacing. I think on a dusky night walking through the park, I think that I wouldn't walk their way. Very intimidating.
Still to come.
Hello.
The problems on the estate run far deeper than the Duchess thought.
Blunt walls are here. That's fine. You got mugged by a young kid. I'm not condoning what they do, but they haven't got much hope, have they?
The Duchess of York is spending a week in Northern Moor, Manchester.
There we go.
To work out how to tackle problems blighting life on the estate.
Is it? Hello, boss. This is the Duchess of York. Who's that? You probably think I'm the local pub. I'm not. I really am me. I really am here.
I thought you were a lot taller. I don't know why. Yeah, well, I was...
Really? You think I was taller? You're very good looking, you know.
Thank you, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Well, yeah,
we've got.
Hello, Anne.
The Duchess has come to what is traditionally the centre of life in a community, the local pub or working men's club, to find out why there's such apathy among young men on the estate.
I thought you didn't want me in here. So this is it, is it?
This is it.
How do you do? Nice to meet you. You're the boss?
Yeah.
El Presidente?
Yeah, that's right.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello. You allow women in here?
Oh, yes, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Us ladies allowed?
Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Would you sign there, please?
Yes. Visitor's name. That's me. Hello. Hello.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. You all right?
Yourself?
Yeah, lovely. Thanks.
Good.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Hello. Nice to see you.
What do you drink?
Not much, really. She lied badly.
What would you like?
Well, I'll take a little bit, a half of cider, please. Okay, so how much is that then, please?
£1.50.
£1 for threepence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how to play pool. Eamon, can't you teach me?
In the pool room, she meets Eamon, who has lived in Northern Moor for the last 10 years. With over one in five young men jobless in Withinshaw, the Duchess is keen to find out what opportunities there are for young men on the estate.
Oh, yes! Yes! Look, Andy didn't go in. So, Eamon, what do you do?
Well, to be quite honest, I just got laid off last week from work.
So what are you going to do now, then?
There's no work about business, so you can't go looking for work, because there's a bad time in it, in the economy, so you just have to wait, see what happens. Yeah, but something needs to be done, because it's not getting any better. And, yeah, how can I put it? Government after government are just leaving it, and it's getting worse and worse and worse. Do you know what I mean? And eventually it will end up like America, won't it? See it now, can't it? I mean, there was a bloke walked out of here apparently last Friday and got mugged by a young kid.
No. And is that mugging and stabbing or just mugging and stealing?
He hit him with a baseball bat or something, so I had to get his wallet off him. But that's what's happening. That's how it is. The young males are bored, ain't they? I mean, I'm not condoning what they do, but they haven't got much hope, have they?
We've got a major uphill battle here. And if this is the sort of general consensus of they're either bored, they've got nothing to do, they just aren't the jobs. Therefore, why should they bother to get educated? Why should they bother to get trained? They see their peers not getting jobs, so where is the hope? Most of the young people we speak to here are saying, oh, don't care, oh, nothing to do, bored, no jobs. There's just no hope. And it must be very difficult to live without hope.
It's late. And the Duchess decides to return to the B&B. A 15-minute walk away. It's the first time she's been out on the estate at night.
It really is very sinister. Because these young people are frightened themselves, and they are dangerous because they don't know what to do. And these guys come out with their mobile telephones and their knives as an accessory. Smoking, drinking, anything else to do around here?
No, not really.
It's dead. Nothing to do, just standing about. Get pulled by the police for nothing to do.
Yeah, I bet you get a lot of aggro for it. Don't you?
Yeah.
So you get your alcohol, you light your fags, and just lie against this and just hang here.
Yeah. Oh, wait.
Get pissed most of the time, and that's it.
Get pissed. And how do you pay for your alcohol?
EMA.
EMA.
What?
Is EMA.
From college.
What's that mean?
College money.
Like, oh, I just have money from somewhere, somehow.
Do you find that there's no hope for you?
Not for me, you know. No. Got hope for me, obviously, but not
right.
For Harry.
Right. What is your hope for you?
Me? to snake a while.
It's like no one's listening to you.
Yeah.
I mean, you're young people that deserve a chance to get what you need in life, don't you agree?
The next morning, the scale of trouble on the estate seems overwhelming.
There's a lot of problems, a lot of violence, a lot of silly muggings, which don't need to be happening, a lot of sort of drugs, really, and we need to address all these situations. Don't know, maybe I've taken on too big a task, who knows?
The Duchess needs inspiration if she's going to help the people of Northern Moor find a solution.
When you sit and sell it to ITV and you think, come on, you can do this. And then it's now when you actually get here, you think, or on the way, you think, whoa, look good on paper, but now deliver.
She's heard about a lady in Blackpool called Julie Bascom, who has turned a community around successfully. In 2004, Julie bought a house on Harrison Street in the town and soon became a target for local youths.
The crime was obviously they broke windows, they damaged people's cars, they burgled houses. Things were put through my letterbox, like dog muck, etc. But it scared me if they put some fire things through my door. That was the fear that was in myself. It was scary and intimidating. You know, you learn to sleep with baseball bats by the side of your bed. You just don't know what to expect.
She didn't want to leave the area in Blackpool where she comes from, and she really fought very hard to make sure that she changed the area rather than the area change her. So, in fact, she's a great example of what we're trying to achieve.
I was scared stiff.
Yeah.
Absolutely petrified, because I had to get past 60, 70 youths at night. Then it was a case of, right, OK, then what do I do here? Do I get intimidated enough to go in my door, don't come out, can't have a life, move? And I'm not being funny. I used to say if I move to another area,
it doesn't happen
it's
then.
Not going to happen again.
Yeah.
So it was a case of, well, OK, then, we will stick it out and see. I mean, my mum was scared for me. She was saying, look, I'll try and help you. We'll try and move you to another house. And I said, but why should I?
But instead of blaming the youths for their behaviour, Julie turned her energy towards getting them off the streets. She set up a youth centre called Dream Scheme that accepts young people, no matter how badly behaved.
Could you explain how Dream Scheme works?
We reward good behaviour with points. They get 2 points if they come in an evening, because these days it takes a lot for kids to commit to something, and sometimes the mates might be playing in the park, so it's easy, oh, well, I'll go to them. But so we say, no, if you come, you get 2 points.
Yeah.
When they get 50 points, they get a £10 gift voucher that can be spent in a different number of shops.
You obviously thought of this idea for Dream Scheme, but is it? Do you believe it's because you want to inspire children, or what? Why did you start it?
Because I think every kid needs a chance, yeah. And there's not a lot of things that you can do that kids can go to for free, and they can come here for free. And they're being kids. I think kids these days grow up so quick, and here we try and keep them as kids for as long as possible.
And who actually funds all that?
We beg and borrow and apply for as much funding as we can get.
I think for me it's been very interesting to listen to you, that you have had the tenacity to go on fighting for the rights of children that maybe are trying to shut you out, but you've gone through their barriers.
It's finding something that they're interested in. And if you can break that barrier and become a friend and try and meet them halfway, you might not like having to do what you're doing. And a lot of the times you might feel like throwing the towel in. But if you do it, who else is going to help them?
From meeting Julie and from being with Julie, I now realise that I think there's hope. I know there's hope now. Julie's done it. I must remain steadfast too, to my dreams of making, to getting Britain back on track.
Buoyed by her visit to Blackpool, the Duchess now has a plan that she thinks can help the people of Northern Moor.
My vision and my dream would be that we could bring the village hall concept, i.e. community centres, back to Northern Moor.
and then every council in the whole of Great Britain copies our example and the blueprint of what we've achieved here.
And she has a novel idea about how she can achieve it, by bringing the mothers together on the estate.
The mothers not only are the CEOs of the house, but they also are the people that intrinsically keep the family prosperity together, the family unity. And I think if we can unite all the mothers and really get people moving, I think we can do it.
Dawn has said she is willing to help the Duchess whatever she decides and thinks the idea has been a long time coming.
I've been saying for years that they need a community room round here. You should have somewhere to go and say, I've got a problem with this. There should be somewhere where they can come, even the old people, and do like stupid pottery classes or something. And there's got to be something for them to do other than sit in the house in front of a gas fire.
If the Duchess is going to bring her vision to life, first she needs to help find a property on the estate.
I think after the success from Julie, she did a great job with her community centre in her local area. I think we can take full advantage from her knowledge. So the next thing I've got to do is find a building.
Do you have any sort of thing? What I need is something in the Sale Road area. I'm working with ITV. Is there any chance of finding a building in the Sale area? And you're a letting agency. Maybe I can one day come in and speak to your boss and see if we couldn't. So I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll get my assistant to ring you back now.
The Duchess's inquiries draw a blank. But the next day, she hears about a building adjacent to the shops at Sale Circle.
It's Bernard.
Yes, ma'am.
Lovely to see you.
It's a property that Bernard Kane, chair of the local residents association, has had his eye on for a while.
And then on the ground floor, there's a big meeting room. We've got a meeting in there. And back of there will be the kitchen, followed by the toilet. Then there's another meeting room. And that front room on the ground floor is another big meeting room.
What was this property?
This is an empty property at the moment. It used to house the Manchester Community Transport.
It seems like it's completely like it's made in heaven. It seems almost too good to be true. What are the chances of us getting this building?
Every chance, yeah. I had a meeting with the council last week, and they're looking at it.
So therefore we could get everybody that wants to be involved. And rally a team of people.
We've got the talent in the community, provided the community comes forward and does it. We've got plenty of talent in this community.
Bernard, we know our game plan. What do we need to kick this off and to make this happen?
Well, really to ensure that the council will agree to give it us.
What you need to know is that I'm here to come
with
you.
That as well.
I'm in service, so if you want me to come to the council with you or if you want me to come along, let's do it. For me, this is a big breakthrough. This is an incredible bit of property, but it's no means done. And I said to him, look, do I need to come to the council with you? What will it take? What do I need to do to make this happen? And if it means I come back and go to the council, I'll do that. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
Still to come. The Duchess now needs the mums on the estate to fight for the project.
At that point, I gripped her by her hair and slapped her a few times.
Right.
But when she asks Dawn, there's a problem.
Are you worried that you're going to do all this and then you're not going to get a job working in the community centre?
There's no chance that I would get a job.
The Duchess thinks she has a plan to help the people of Northern Moor, a community centre that will bring young and old together. But she's going to need the mums on the estate to help make it happen.
If we can save a group of kids, we've tried, haven't we?
Yeah, I think so.
Dawn and the Duchess are on the way to pick up Dawn's son Callum from school.
I've seen that, and the cover is blown.
Hey, the cover is blown.
Where is that?
The cover is blown. Wait
for me.
Yeah.
Don't say hello.
Sometimes you have to time it, so you might have 5 seconds to get through.
Dawn has signed up to help the Duchess turn the estate around. But the Duchess soon realises there's a problem. 5 years ago, Callum said he was being bullied at his old school, where Dawn worked as a dinner lady.
It went on over a period of 12 months.
Right.
Callum was coming home and saying, he's done this, he's done this, he's done this. Mm-hmm. And there was marks on him, and my friends and neighbours and family all saw these marks. Walked into the nursery one day, picked Callum up, and Callum actually approached the mother. He was only about 3 at the time, and said, your little boy's been hitting me again today. Which, on that point, I've just turned back round and come back in that nursery, which was a major mistake. At that point, I gripped her by her hair and slapped her a few times.
Right.
Dawn was convicted of battery for the incident and now has a criminal record. As a result, it's difficult for her to work with children.
Well, I can never foster again. I can't. I have kids here, and I feed them and I look after them, but I could never foster them again.
You were a foster mother.
I have fostered a few children.
So
everything was took off me. I lost everything.
I mean, I don't have a criminal record, but I know what it feels like. When I got separated, and I had been humiliated in front of the world's press.
Right.
I used to take my children to school, and parents used to walk on the other side of the street.
Oh, I had all that.
Yeah, and they would just look, and they'd do the up and down, and just walk off going like that. Did you have that?
Right, I had that.
And but I had it for probably a good 8 years, when nobody, and it's not, it wasn't until really I did the Hull programme that I dared to come back to Britain, because I thought everybody believed that I had, you know, let everyone down.
And the Duchess now thinks Dawn deserves a second chance, despite her criminal record.
I'm thinking that when I met you and everyone's spoken so highly about you, that I would employ you to be my voice in this area.
I have no idea about that.
So you would be working for me. And quite frankly, you are a lovely, wonderful lady and a good friend of mine now, and therefore you're good enough for me. Everyone else can swing, quite frankly.
I just thought I was doing it to get it up and running, and then I was out of there.
Well, to be honest with you, Dawn, the best news is, how lovely is that as an example of the person you are, that you are prepared to make a difference without any reward at the end?
You've upset me.
You didn't know I was going to believe in you, did you?
No. Meet the fish.
Where's the fish?
A bit of bog roll will do with him. I'm just doing it away. What I was doing for the community, I thought I was doing for the community. I never thought I stood to gain one thing out of it. I just decided that something has to be done, and if I was the one to stick my neck on the block, well, let's do it. But never ever thought I'd gain anything out of it at all. So it was a shock. A nice shock. And I know certain people that'll be very proud of me and 100% behind me, but I'm just getting used to the idea, really.
As the Duchess's first week in Northern Moor draws to a close, she says goodbye to Dawn and her family.
Thanks for everything you've done for coming in Northern Moor.
Thank you. Thank you for looking after us. Don't worry, we'll stick together.
All right, mate. Take care.
Have a nice rest.
Thanks a lot, love.
Soon the Duchess will return to fight for a community centre on the estate. But on the long drive back to London, she knows that making it happen will not be easy.
One of the main reasons why I'm worried is that I've taken on an enormous project. What I'm hoping is that we do get the house, we get supported, we can show the local community that it is possible. I just think that this is a very big project that we've taken on. I've taken on.
The cavalry's arrived.
Yes, it has.
Next time, they get the building, but the Duchess and Dawn's project meets fierce resistance.
Where did the bullets go in?
One there and the other window on the other side. We've got a crazy lunatic out there with a gun, with a vendetta against the building. I'm putting people's lives at risk saying that. I'm absolutely gutted that we've got this far for some idiots to come along and threaten everybody. No, I've got work.
Well, it's 80s London and a notorious group of bank robbers are out in force. Movie time on ITV4, that's Tuesday, starting next. A knife-wielding criminal is subdued by a stun gun, all part of the latest technology used by the force in police camera action, coming up after the news.